When it comes to building hot rods, few people can match the sheer creativity of Ed Big Daddy Roth. His creations are icons in the world of hot rodding, and many of them have become legends. But he didn't build the cars for glory. Roth just loved what he was doing.
We'd look for parts, suspension parts, flathead parts, dual intake manifolds, those kind of things. We would look around, we'd be messing with putting it together. And so I would be painting at the car shows, and just kept on going, and guys would say, well, come to my show. Luckily, I had a trailer in the early days when anybody else was driving their cars. I had a small trailer, and I was able to go to Arizona and New Mexico, where the other guys from California, they just wanted to stay in California. They thought I was nuts for going to the other car show.
Roth's first completely fabricated hot rod was the Outlaw. He made the frame out of the rails of a 29 Ford and added an old Cadillac engine. The Outlaw was such a hit that the Revell Model Company contacted Roth about producing a model of the car. At this time, Roth didn't have a nickname, and that bothered Revell. They felt a cool moniker would help the sales of the model.
Well, in high school, they called me Eddie Spaghetti, and I said, no, you can't use that. So he says, well, how many children do you have? I says, five. He says, we will call you Big Daddy then. I says, that's fine. That was 40 years ago, and it's worked for me ever since.
Roth went on to build many more hot rods. He was even contracted to build a car for the Addams Family television show. But the show was canceled before the Druid Princess was finished. Some of his more famous rods are the Beatnik Bandit, Rotar, and Mysterion. Then he moved into the world of motorcycles and trikes, three-wheeled creations that were part car, part chopper. When Hot Rod Magazine refused to publish photos he had taken of choppers, Roth founded and published Choppers Magazine out of his home for 3 years before he sold the enterprise. He's even built motorized little red wagons. But Roth's most famous creation doesn't even have an engine. It's the cartoon character, Rat Fink.
The guys at in the late 50s were forming car clubs, you know, the Buccaneers and the Clutch Artists and the 302s and the SCTA, they were all clubs that needed identification. So instead of going out and buying a rear window and putting that club on it like they do in the 90s now, we would wear t-shirts and put our name in the back of the t-shirt along with the picture that went along with the title. And it sort of evolved into where, well, the Disney guy says you can't use the Disney characters. The Hanna-Barbera guy says you can't use the Hanna-Barbera guy. So I said, well, I'll make up my own. So I played around with a mouse and a rat and a cat and a dog, but the Rat Fink was something the kids always came back and asked for more. And every time you see a Rat Fink, you know the guy's got a hot rod someplace.
Roth has always been more of an artist than a mechanic, and his cars have long been considered works of art.